Hello everyone, welcome back to Chunda DIY. In today's video, I'll be showing you how to crochet a ruffle top. It is really easy and friendly for beginners. For this top, I'm making inside small, but we have the back lace to adjust the size, and I also showing you how to make it bigger too. Okay, now let's get into the video. First, we are going to make the underbust part. So for this top, I'm using 2 slip stitch. To begin, make a slip knot. And we are going to make the foundation chain multiple by 4. For me, I made 128. It is equal 21 inches length. If you guys want your top bigger, please add more chains. After you got your desired fit, then add one more chain. For me, it is equal 129 chains. Remember, your foundation chains must be have the odd number. So you can see this short foundation chains. It is just a sample showing you how to make a tulip stitch. You can follow the description that I show on the screen or follow your measurement. To make tulip stitch, skip 3 chains and make double crochet into the 4th chain. To make double crochet, yarn over, insert the hook into the loop, yarn over and pull up a loop. And now you have 3 loops on your hook. Yarn over, pull through 2 loops, and yarn over, pull through 2 loops again. After you have made a double crochet, then chain 2. Then make single crochet into the next chain. To make single crochet, insert the hook into the loop, yarn over and pull up a loop, and now you have 2 loops on your hook. Yarn over and pull through all 2 loops. After you have made a single crochet, next skip 2 chains and make 2 double crochet into the 3rd chain. After you had 2 double crochet into the same loop, then chain 2 and make single crochet into the next chain. Keep repeating this by skip 2 chain and make 2 double crochet into the 3rd chain. Then chain 2 and make single crochet into the next chain until you reach the end of the row. Then I will meet you back again. After you reach the end of the row, and this is what the first row of 2 loop stitch looks like. Next, for row 2, chain 2, turn your work, and we are going to make 2 double crochet into the chain 2 space. After you got 2 double crochet into the chain 2 space, then chain 2 and make single crochet into the chain 2 space. Next, we are going to skip this stitch and working the stitch into the chain 2 space. Keep repeating this by make 2 double crochet into the chain 2 space. Then chain 2 and make single crochet into the chain 2 space until you have 1 last chain 2 space. Then I will meet you back again. So this is your last chain 2 space. We are going to make 2 double crochet into that chain 2 space. Then chain 2 and make single crochet into this last double crochet stitch. And this is what it looks like. For the next row, we are going to repeat row 2 until you reach row 11. It is equal 3.5 inches length. If you guys want your top longer, please add more rows. After you reach row 11, next we are going to make the bust part. To begin, fold the top into two pieces and use stitch marker to mark at the middle part. So you can see this curve here. For one side, I have four curves, and for the other side, I also have four curves the same. Next, continue from where your last stitch is. For row 12, chain 2, turn your work, and we are going to make the tulip stitch by repeat the same thing like row 2 until you have one last chain 2 space from the stitch marker. Then I will meet you back again. After you have made two double crochet into the last chain 2 space, then chain 2 and remove the stitch marker and make single crochet into the stitch that we marked. And this is what it looks like. Next, keep repeating the same thing like row 2 until you reach row 25. It is equal 4 inches. It's the measurement from the under bust until the chest. Please add more rows if you want it longer. And this is what it looks like after you reach row 25. Then chain 1 and cut off the yarn. Next, I'm gonna show you how to make the other side. So this is the wrong side of the stitch. And this is the right side of the stitch. We are going to work on the wrong side of the stitch. To begin, attach the yarn into this chain 2 space. And chain 2. Then make 2 double crochet into the chain 2 space. After you have made 2 double crochet, then chain 2 and make single crochet into the chain 2 space. And then we are going to make the 2 slip stitch until the end of the row, but repeat the same thing like the other side. After you reach row 25, the same like the first side, then chain 1 and cut off the end. Next, we are going to make the ruffle strap for the top. Please try the top on your body, and for this part, it is the middle part of your top. Try it on your body and use stitch marker to mark where you want to make the strap. And then fold the top into 2 pieces and use stitch marker to mark the other side. To begin, attach the yarn into the stitch that we marked. For row 1, chain 1 and make single crochet into the next 4 stitches. If you want the strap bigger, please add more single crochet stitches. Next, for row 2 until row 58, chain 1, turn your work, and make single crochet into the next 4 stitches. And this is what the strap looks like after you reach row 58. It is equal 12 inches length. If you guys want the strap longer, please add more rows. If you want it shorter, please make less rows. Next, we are going to connect the strap into the back part of the top. To Turn your strap like this, and we are going to make slip stitch both sides together. To make slip stitch, continue inside the hook into the other side loop. Yarn over and pull through all the loops. Keep repeating this by insert the hook into both sides loop. Yarn over and pull through all the loops until you reach the end of the row, then I will meet you back again. After you reach the end of the row, then chain 1 and turn your work. And this is what it looks like on the right side. After you reach the end of the row, then we are going to continue make a wrap for sleeves. But if your last stitch end here, you have to chain 1 and cut off the yarn and attach the yarn into the side. Next, continue from where your last stitch is and we are going to make single crochet into every stitch around the strap until the end of the row. Then I will meet you back again. After you reach the end of the row, then make slip stitch. Next, for row 1, turn your work and make slip stitch into the next 3 stitches. After you have made 3 slip stitch stitches, then make single crochet increase by make 2 single crochet into the same stitch. After you got 2 single crochet into the same stitch, then repeat this into the next stitch. And now you got 2 groups of single crochet increase. Then we are going to make half double crochet increase into the next 3 stitches. To make half double crochet, yarn over, insert the hook into the loop, yarn over and pull up a loop, and now you have 3 loops on your hook. Then yarn over and pull through all 3 loops. Keep repeating this into the same loop. After you got 2 half double crochet into the same stitch, then repeat this into the next 2 stitches. And now after you got 3 groups of half double crochet increase, then we are going to make double crochet increase into the next 5 stitches. After you got 5 groups of double crochet increase, then we are going to make treble crochet increase. To make treble crochet, yarn over twice. Then insert the hook into the loop. Yarn over and pull up a loop. And now you got 4 loops on your hook. Yarn over, pull through 2 loops. And yarn over, pull through another 2 loops. Then yarn over, pull through another 2 loops again. And this is how we make treble or triple crochet. Keep repeating this into the same loop. After you got 2 treble crochet into the same loop, then keep repeating this into every stitch around until you have 13 last stitches. Then I will meet you back again. After you have made treble crochet increase into every stitch until you have 13 last stitches, then we are going to make double crochet increase for 5 times and half double crochet increase for 3 times and single crochet increase for 2 times and slip stitch for 3 times. It is the same number of the stitches that we start at the beginning, but we are working in reverse. Next, for row 2, turn your work and make slip stitch for 6 times. Remember, start from row 2, we are not going to make increase anymore. After you got 6 stitches of slip stitch, then make half double crochet into the next 5 stitches. Then make double crochet into the next 10 stitches. Then we are going to make treble or triple crochet into every stitch around until you have 21 last stitches. Then I will meet you back again. After you had 21 last stitches, then we are going to working reverse by make 10 double crochet and then 6 half double crochet and then 5 slip stitch. After you reach the end of the row, then chain 1 and cut off the yarn. Next, repeat the same thing to the other side. For the remaining yarn, please use the darning needle to weave in. Next, for the middle part, make a slip knot and then chain long enough for the front tight. And start weaving the foundation chain into the top. And this is what the front tie or ruched top looks like. Next, we are going to make the shell stitch around the bottom of the top. Turn your top and we are going to working on the right side of the top. To begin, attach the yarn and chain one. Then make 6 double crochet into this big loop. It is where we made chain 2. After you got 6 double crochet into the same loop, and we are going to make slip stitch into this big loop. It is the chain 2 space. After you have made a slip stitch, and this is what the shell stitch looks like. Next, keep repeating the same thing by skip the small loop and make 6 double crochet into this big loop. And after you got 6 double crochet and make slip stitch into this big loop. Keep repeating this until you reach the end of the row. Then I will meet you back again. Thank you. After you reach the end of the row, for the last shell, I made 7 double crochet stitches and then make slip stitch into the very last stitch of the row. Then chain 1 and cut off the yarn. For the remaining yarn, please use the needle to weave in. And this is what it looks like. Next, we are going to make the back lace. I use 2 strands of yarn because I want the lace a little bit thick. Then make a slip knot. And chain long enough for your back lace. For me, I make it until I reach 40 inches length. And now your ruffle top is done. If you like this tutorial, please don't forget to click like and leave a positive comment down below. Stay safe and stay healthy, and I will see you guys in the next video. Bye bye.